This is an electric circuit and an essential part of all modern devices like computers, cars, household appliances, or medical equipment. They're literally everywhere, and without them, life as we know it would not be possible. Hello everybody, my name is Samuel and I'm a PhD student at the Material Physics Center in San Sebastian. We're used to see constant technological progress. Computers are getting faster, cameras have higher and higher resolution, and hard disks have also more and more memory. Imagine that only 60 years ago, a hard disk like this had memory of 5 megabytes, just enough to save the picture of this cat. Nowadays, the individual parts that make up electric circuits are getting smaller and smaller, and in order to keep up with this high demand for progress and technological innovation, new materials have to be found that fulfill this new requirement. This is where we material scientists come into play. Our job is to find these new materials and investigate their electronic, magnetic, and chemical properties. In order to study these properties, we use very sophisticated techniques that allow us to look at the materials on a very small scale and understand how the atoms are arranged and how they interact with each other. Currently, I'm investigating two substances called cobalt dichloride and cobalt dibromide. These two materials are known as transition metal D halides because they contain a transition metal like cobalt and a halide like chlorine or bromine. These materials have a layered structure with very weak interlayer interactions, which makes it easy to peel off one by one to study individually. And materials with this property are called van der Waals materials. The most interesting thing when studying these incredibly thin layers is that at this scale, the laws of quantum mechanics cannot be neglected anymore and cause the materials to behave very differently from what we would normally expect. This often unintuitive behavior is exactly what we're looking for and trying to understand, to then build new, faster and better technologies. To give you an idea how sensitive these measurements are, here you can see an image of atoms in one single atomic layer of cobalt dichloride on top of a very flat gold surface. This is why we need ultra-high vacuum chambers like this one, where all the air was sucked out and we're able to measure in 100% clean environment. Using a variety of different, highly precise measurement techniques, we're able to discover the properties we desire and that will help bring humanity to a bright and green future. Yo investigo, yo soy CSIC.